Get ready to match the stars. Leslie Nielsen, Rhett Summers, Charles Nelson Reiter, Barbara Rose, Richard Dawson, and Joyce Bulavant as we play the star-studded Big Money Match Game 77. And now, here's the star of Match Game 77, Gene Rayburn.
Hey, Johnny O. How are you?
Good.
Thank you for joining us. Well, we got a couple of surprises here today. Nice to see you. You haven't been around here in a long time. You have two? In case one wears out.
Nice to see you.
And we
you
have.
You might tell us his name.
Yes.
Murph.
Everybody knows
Murph Griffin.
Leslie Nielsen, it's been over a year since you've been here, isn't it?
It's been a couple of years.
Oh.
I've just been traveling a lot.
Yeah. Really?
Yeah.
Where have you been?
I've been to Amsterdam and the Philippines and Hong Kong and South America and Timbuktu.
I'm a lamb.
That's right.
Yeah.
Your law's after him. Now, we have a little tradition. I suppose because you work a lot, you don't have a chance to see this show. But whenever we got a new kid on the block, we have a special way of welcoming her. Talk to each other for a second here while I welcome this pretty girl from Busting Loose. You don't think I'm going to kiss your hand, do you?
Nice to have you with us.
I hope you enjoy it. Dawson's next. Let's say hello to the current champ, Julie Yeager.
Yay, Julie.
Yay, Julie. How do you feel?
I feel wonderful.
She's won a lot of money, you know, and she just won another game as the time expired last time. At this moment, she has $11,400. And you're going to have a shot at over the $5,000 in a moment or so. We'll see how that works out after we see how this works out. Here we are, ready to go. Now, Julie, there it is. You've been here before, you know how it goes. We'll begin by pointing out to you that we canvassed a whole bunch of people in a studio audience, maybe in this very studio, not too long ago, and we got their most frequent response to this. James Earl Blank. And the answer they gave most often will get you $500 if you match it, $250 for matching the second most frequent answer, and $100 for matching the third. And three of our six celebrities are permitted to assist by suggesting answers.
Okay, Brett?
How about James Earl Jones?
James Earl Jones.
Charles?
I'm sending a sympathy card to the third one. James Earl Ray.
James Earl Ray, yeah.
Richard?
No, don't call me.
You know, when I heard James Earl Jones, I said, oh, boy, where do we go?
James
Who's going to be
Ray.
Third this time?
James Earl Brown.
Who's he?
Well, I don't know.
Oh,
just a second. Let me hear a couple here, you yo-yo. James Earl Carter?
James Earl Carter.
What's that?
That's right, Carter.
James Earl Carter?
Who's he?
I didn't know his name.
James Earl Carter. Are you sure? All right.
What James Earl Rayburn.
What? Not, there is no James Earl Rayburn.
How do you
what
know?
Is your
James
final?
Earl Brown Carter. It's the best of both worlds.
Right. James Earl, what do you want? James Earl Brown, is that what you want?
Yes.
Okay. James Earl Brown, James Earl Ray, and James Earl Jones. What do you want?
I have to go with Brett on James Earl Jones.
James Earl Jones. There we go.
He is, but I know the name.
Now, let's find out where it is and if it's there at all. May we see the $100 response? James Earl Carter.
He's using the other name now.
Oh, I see. Jimmy.
Jimmy.
Yeah, he eliminated the Earl. Jimmy Carter. Okay. Now let's see if we got James Earl Jones under the $250 response. Yeah! Who do you think?
Ray.
Who else?
Brown?
No. Well, he's on the bottom there. I don't know. Slide it, Earl.
Ray.
James Earl Ray. Okay.
It's really Ray Jones.
Now, You picked up an additional $250. You're going to play for 10 times that amount. Remember, a $2,500. Then we'll give you the money if you'll match one of them exactly.
Richard.
Richard who?
Richard Dawson.
Okay, I just want you to make sure.
James Earl Brown.
Gotcha.
Richard All Brown. Right.
Now, let's see. Another 2,500, 13, 14. Maybe close to 15,000 bucks here. Let's find out what happens. Good luck to you. Maple blank. It's M-A-P-L-E blank.
Did you say
Maple? M-A-P-L-E. All right. Now, he's finished. Now, you tell us an answer that will match his, and we give you the $2,500. It's that simple. What do you say? Maple.
Syrup.
Syrup. Maple syrup. Maple syrup.
Yeah, that never even occurred to me. I was so hung up with James Earl Syrup. Oh.
Congratulations.
$14,150. Very good.
Okay. Want to meet another player?
Yes, sir.
Here comes Susan Souchere. Let's welcome her right now. Hello there. You two ladies know each other?
Indeed we do, oh Julie.
Gosh, I was sure one of you was going to say maple syrup, and the other one was going to say maple sugar, but
sugar.
It worked out okay. Hello, Susan.
How are you, Gene?
I'm very well. How are you? What's
Fine.
It say on your front?
That says Madeline Island, Wisconsin. It's in Lake Superior. That's where I live.
Uh-huh.
There's La Pointe, the village that I live in.
Oh, I see. Where is true north?
Straight up.
Oh, I see. I love your longitude and latitude. Now, you live where?
I live in Madeline Island in Lake Superior.
I don't believe you.
Yes, it's
Is Madeline Island a little island where they have an old Ford tri-motor aircraft that goes back and forth
no,
to the mainland?
You're thinking of Mackinac, I believe, which is in Michigan.
Right.
We are in Lake Superior, about 90 miles due east of Duluth, and we are a part of a national park now.
Is Madeline Island the one that has the wild wolf wolf
no,
pack?
That's Devil's Island.
That's Devil's Island. Oh, no.
Well, Devil's Island is a part of our complex.
It is.
Yes, and we have a lot of wolves, too.
Yes. Well, naturally, they're alone on that island, and they get a little randy out there. Now, are you married, Susan?
I'm married. I'm married to a physician. We have 8 children, 5 of which were born in 28 months. And I announced...
Wait a minute. 12, 24, 36. How'd you do that?
Wasn't easy.
Is the doctor your husband in show business also?
Well, since he produced this little fiasco,
yeah.
Yes, he is.
So I take it you've had some twins or triplets or
something. Yes, we had 2 sets of twins and a singleton in that first 28 months.
Well.
And then we decided that they were pretty cute, so we went on and did it 3 more times.
Yes. Have you quit now?
Oh, yes.
Oh, I see.
For sure.
You vacationing out here?
I came out really to do this.
Oh, no kidding.
Well, we came to Las Vegas to a medical convention.
Oh, I see. And here you are. Well, we're honored to have you with us, Susan.
Thank
we'll start
you.
This game in a moment or so, but right now we have to do a little business with America. Here we go. New game. Susan, you may have A or B.
B, please.
All right. Are you ready?
Yeah.
When the dentist... What?
Just a second. Come here.
Right.
You got something wet there. Look. April Fool.
It's April Fool's Day.
Oh, it is.
You never mentioned it.
Yeah.
Richard, I want to meet. Well, it's nice to know he takes the joke well.
Today is the 1 of April. Yeah. By Jove, I forgot about that. Now listen to this. When the dentist looked into King Kong's mouth, he said, I bet you just ate a baseball team. Your mouth is full of blanks.
Just ate a baseball team?
A baseball team. The dentist said to King Kong, as he looked into his mouth, I bet you just ate a baseball team. Your mouth is full of blanks.
Cute.
Right.
2 sets of twins in 28 months.
Wow.
Were you depressed?
No. Not until later.
Is that the 2 sets before?
You had 4 kids in diapers?
Five. Yes, because
some diapers.
Other activity. Leslie, did you put it in the slot there?
What for? What? Oh,
you put it in the slot, and that turns on the light, and then I know you're finished writing. You must obey the rules, or you will go back to one of those series which you hate so much.
Jeez. Hello, senor.
When the dentist looked into King Kong's mouth, he said, I bet you just ate a baseball team. Your mouth is full of blanks.
Mitts.
Mitts. Now, wait a minute. Anything connected with a team, mitts, you know, bats, all of that stuff, all of those are good answers. Mitts who?
Gator.
Mitt me, that's mitt who. What do you mean, mitt who?
Mitt sound.
Mitt. Leslie, what do you say?
Well, I was thinking of things, you know, like candy or, you know, something that you could, all I thought of was balls.
Okay. Baseball, right? Right?
What?
Are you ready?
This window's closed. You'll have to go elsewhere. I'm sorry I didn't say mitts for a woman who had 5 kids in diapers in 28 months. Bad.
That's another good one.
While we're plugging islands, Whitby Island is off of Seattle and the home of Daily Bread, a terrific bakery if you happen to be in the neighborhood. Of correct answers.
Oh!
So there's one for Susan. Barbara? King Kong is at the dentist. The dentist said, I bet you just ate a baseball team. Your mouth is full of blanks. She said, mitts.
Well, I thought it was probably very dark in there.
Yes.
So I said, bats.
Bats. Oh. Very clever.
Player.
Yeah, very good play.
I thought
on
it was
words.
Very light in there, and I said, bats.
Now, what do you say?
Well, I thought that he probably had a lot of holes in there if he was at the dentist, and he'd fill them up with balls.
Balls. Okay. Baseball players wear gray flannel suits, too, don't they?
Oh, yes.
There could have been buttons and all of that in there. All right, that's yours. Julie, you ready for yours? This is it.
Have a ball.
Jacques Cousteau said, he says, on our ship, we just held a song fest. You know what is a song fest? Mm-hmm. What is a song fest?
Singing songs.
Oh, very good for you. He says, I hit the highest note when my first mate... slipped a blank into my wetsuit. Hit a high note, you see.
Where my first kiss him in the eye. Love his whole idea.
He slipped a blank into my wetsuit and all. Immediately became a lyric soprano. And the Metropolitan Opera offered me a contract. And so I am no longer living with the fishes.
Gist of the question.
Oh, you do understand. But start writing.
We'll call you.
Do old man Periwinkle instead.
Will you write something?
Here, do a French old man Periwinkle.
Sacre bleu.
Voulez-vous? No. Hello, Julie.
Hello.
Here we go. Whoops, we're not ready. Now we're ready. Jacques Cousteau said, he says, on our ship we just held a song fest. I hit the highest note when my first mate slipped a blank into my wetsuit.
A shark?
A shark into my wetsuit. You'll boo anything, won't you? You are weird. Hello.
Well, I thought of shark.
Yeah? But I wrote.
I thought it'd be a little heavy company. I wrote snorkel.
Oh, snorkel.
Well, it's a try.
Yeah.
Boo.
No, that's right. There'd be lots of snorkels aboard. That's one possible answer. Brett?
Would you like to see another one?
Yes. Round one questions are tough, you know.
Yes. Well, you said songfest. I thought that was the operative word. So I thought possibly the first mate was the conductor.
Yes.
Of the songfest. So I said a pointed baton.
A pointed baton. Okay.
It's
baton.
Not good, but it's not, you know. It's early in the show, folks.
Right. Chuck?
All batons are pointed. Did you ever see one that wasn't?
A doctor. I'll tell you something to put a point on.
An electric eel!
An electric eel! That's right. A guy who composed that aria. Un bel di! Hello there.
Hello.
Are you ready?
Yes.
Go. I hit the highest note when my first mate slipped a blank into my wetsuit. And she said, a shark.
Well, we're thinking very closely.
You have a fish?
Yes, I have a little fish.
Oh, a small fish.
Oh, aww.
Okay. All right. A mackerel, tuna.
For really high notes, you always into the wetsuit put
a piranha. Piranha, oh.
A piranha make you soprano. Well-known phrase.
Now the Vienna Boys Choir will sing.
I was going to go to Europe this summer, but I don't have to now.
Good.
You all are making the whole trip. Ready for this one?
No, but do it anyway.
A swordfish.
Oh, yeah. So there we are. Round one, one to nothing in favor of Susan. Round two coming up after this. Come back. Well, we're just about to have a concert here, and we don't have time. We've got to have a little more game here, which we're all anxious to get out of. Now, this is the second and final round, and Susan, again, you have a choice.
B for Bayfield.
Okay. Charles, you do not play, because you matched her in the first round.
Thanks, Gene. I'll just watch this adorable show.
Okay. Thank you, Charles. Dumb Dora is so dumb. Not bad. She thought The Happy Hooker was a book about blanking. Ah. Okay. You got the idea.
I watch all the time.
Oh, good. Yes. Oh, good for you. All right, we'll come over here to Susan. Right in the slot there, Leslie. Do not talk.
Have I done it again?
I wasn't talking to him. I was looking at his answer.
See, we were cheating.
Dumb Dora, so dumb, she thought The Happy Hooker was a book about blanking.
Crocheting.
Crocheting.
I don't know how, but...
Is hooking crocheting? Is that?
Oh, you use a hook in crocheting.
Oh, you do? See, I don't crochet. Do you crochet?
No, I don't crochet.
Oh, I see.
And I don't knit.
Yes.
I hook.
Do you kiss on the first date?
I do every once in a while. Well, crocheting is really very good, but I thought of a happy fisherman.
Oh, that's good. Yay! Very good. Fishermen do indeed use hooks.
Yes. That's true. I just said plain old fishing.
Plain old fishing.
I'm sorry. I thought it was a cheat.
Okay. Now... We come to you, my dear. Are you ready, Barbara?
Yes.
Dumb Dora so dumb she thought The Happy Hooker was a book about... Go.
Well, I'm getting close. I said rug making.
Rug making is a very good answer.
Thank you.
Yeah.
Hooking a rug is a familiar phrase in American
needlework.
That's true. Particularly if you make the rug out of fish.
Fish, yes. Mm.
Very good, Rob.
Fishing. Everybody's going for fishing, Susan. And you live on an island surrounded by water.
Yeah.
And you didn't say fishing.
Yeah.
Dear me.
Well, she didn't have much time for fishing.
What did you say about Barbara's answer?
What did I say about
it?
Yeah. It was an absolutely very good answer, is what I said.
Yes, that's what I thought.
You put rug making, too. Okay. So there you are, and here you are, Julie. You ready? All right, one to tie, two to win. Lonely Lenny said... He said, I just sent away to inflate a date for a life-size doll that you fill with air. You know those things. Now, it's easy to get her started. All you do is blow into her blank. Everybody plays.
Everybody
plays. Listen, while we're plugging islands, let's not forget Treasure Island, Staten Island, and above all... The Island Motel.
He's too much.
Now, what was the question?
Oh. No. Lonely, I just
got it.
Oh, you got it. All right. Here we go. Julie. Lonely Lenny said, I just sent away to inflate a date for a life-size doll that you fill with air. It's easy to get her started. All you do is blow into her blank.
Her ear.
Blow into her ear. All right, one ear to tie, two to win. Leslie?
Yeah, it really depends where they put that little thing, right? That
you, right.
But I prefer ear.
Ear, okay.
Tie score
at
this moment.
Is that it, Rose?
One more ear will win the game, Brett.
I'm sorry. Oh, I said ear.
Ear wins the game. What the rest of it has? Ear, ear, and a big toe. Come on now.
Of course we did.
What did you say?
Big toe.
Oh, yeah.
letting her go.
Someone said big toe over there.
I'm going to take up fishing.
You're going to take up fishing?
Oh, yeah.
Yes. Well, you've got good fish in those waters.
Oh, lots.
Susan, we'll send you some gifts, and we thank you very much for being with us here on
Match
Game 77. Goodbye, my dear. While we're spinning on and off, watch this commercial. Again. Hello, and goodbye. Will you join us next time? Match Game 77. See you next time. Goodbye.